Okay, Mark, we've had the introductions and all the rest of that stuff that goes along with sounding professional. Are we professional? I don't think so.
Yes, I am. What about you?
Okay, we're talking about local council spending.
Don't we always?
To be honest with you, I've got it in for Cheshire West and Chester. I've got some FOIs that are going to go in, which are actually going to cause them a problem. And they're going to have to refer to legal in order to find a way to block it. You know what I mean?
Ooh.
I've had enough of these people, especially coming up to an election. I don't actually rate them, to be honest with you.
Does anybody? Someone votes for them, though. Someone must do somewhere.
Do we need this layer of councillors?
No. Didn't miss them during the great panic of 2020, did we?
No, not at all.
While they were all off on the sick.
Not at all. Anyway, so the town halls are doubling their spending on ridiculous woke jobs. Figures show, after Jeremy Hunt demands an end to public sector waste, as struggling councils risk going bust. Well, go on. What have you got to say about that?
It's no surprise, is it? Well, it's not. We've banged on about this for a while. Can we find some figures? How much have we wasted?
Well, the councils have almost doubled their spending on ridiculous woke jobs in the past 3 years. Figures show almost 52 million of taxpayers' cash has been spent by local authorities on equality, diversity, and inclusion.
Wow, and there's a poverty emergency apparently, but we've got how much? 52 million to just waste on this.
What are we paying these people?
Well, that's a good question, actually, John. So this report was done by the Taxpayers Alliance. So I contacted them myself to do a bit of research and find out, you know, what was going on in Cheshire West. So they sent me a spreadsheet. And apparently there's two diversity officers that work for Cheshire West and Chester Council.
How much?
Sadly, it's redacted. They've refused under a Section 40 to declare the wages.
What's a Section 40? Is that some sort of a legal tool to say we're not going to tell you?
Yeah. Get lost, basically. So I thought, well, we've got to be able to find this out somewhere. So if you do an FOI like the Taxpayers Alliance, you're not going to find out. So I found a story from May 2023.
Ooh.
And it was discussing the wage bills for the top earners in Cheshire.
Right.
Chester West Council. And there are two unspecified roles.
Two?
Two, which match the two redacted roles. So I'm thinking, is this them? Why so secretive? Maybe the £102,000 a year might be the reason for that, John. So I can't 100% guarantee that those two redacted roles are the two secretive ones.
What is the value?
Well, yeah, 100. So that's 204,000 for the pair of them.
What?
That's if that is who we think it is. But is that a coincidence, do you think?
What is the quality and the credibility and the qualification for being accepted to do those jobs?
We're never going to know, are we, John? Because it's all so secretive. You don't know the names. They don't want you to know how much they're getting paid. And they also don't want you to know the type of stuff they're pushing in the council, which is why I found an interesting freedom of information request to Cheshire West and Chester. From a cracking lady. Well, I don't know her personally, but her name's Irene Williams, and she's asked all the questions that I was wanting to ask myself.
I'll take you home, Irene. Oh, no, that's Kathleen. I'm sorry. It was the wrong one. But it's a good one.
It was the wrong one, yeah. So I'm going to just quickly go through the FOI. I'm just going to pick up some of the main points.
Go ahead.
So we're not here all day. So one of the main points, she's asked a few really good questions, and these are the answers. So the council have said, we have funded EDI input into schools and have not requested to have sight of the materials prior to approval, as funding approval is given at an early stage based on applications to the Promoting Equality and Diversity Fund. Then this allows the materials to be developed.
Wow.
So, of course, Irene's asked for the full course material, and they have refused to give the full course material, instead giving vague
full
guidelines.
Full course.
So they've given vague guidelines. So they say we do have an extensive learning offer on EDI. So they've just changed the letters around now. So it's not DEI, it's EDI.
It's not EDI.
And then the only one left was it going to be IED? Oh, no, you can't use that one. Jeez.
No, you can't use that one. EID, IED.
I think it's going to be interesting when they change it to IED. But anyway, so this is an offer on IED. The majority of this is provided in-house, either using our digital learning platform on in-house workshops delivered by our EDI champions. So apparently someone's got some qualifications for this guff. We have also commissioned a number of external providers to deliver specific learning opportunities or to support the ongoing development of our in-house materials. Again, I've spent quite a number of
years... Would you stop banging?
Yeah, I will.
I hear that. I've got to get rid of those on the edit. Stop banging.
Give you some work to do. So again, very secretive. I've been trying for quite some time now to find out who these external agencies are. And you can't. But in this FOI, they've mentioned one, the Proud Trust, and they're actually receiving funding. Yeah, exactly. I think it's about £13,000. And these are the ones who are going and pushing this stuff in schools, which is quite relevant because we did actually a podcast on the gender identity in the schools, didn't we, especially in the local area. And I found one book that was in a school, which was by the Proud Trust, and it was Alienation, which was heavily pushing gender identity ideology. Yeah. And was totally against guidance for being unscientific and non-factual. So we can see where this stuff's starting to filter through from now. So they've also got some nice EDI workshops. So they've got an Equality Act module and the protected, and this deals with the protected characteristics. Now this rings a bell. Now I'm going to bet my last bottom dollar that it's the same as the school where they swap the characteristics.
Yeah.
They swap sex and they swap gender reassignment for gender and obviously the transgender, so they can push that. But the most interesting one was the unconscious bias. So you're all racist, whether you like it or not, basically.
Do you know what? I've seen so much of that, you know, about where there was a Church of England archdeacon who was quite simply basically saying that whiteness is not really the in thing.
No. And you were all born racist, according to this. So.
Well, what I said on a tweet on behalf of all of us was that, quite simply, you can actually follow Welby on his way out, and then you could possibly get together with him and create a new pretend religion called Pretend Church of England.
Yeah. But it is fake, isn't it?
It's fake. I cannot get over it. But anyway, sorry, Mark, I interject with something.
No, that's okay. So, I mean, we've looked at some of this absolute nonsense. I mean, the unconscious bias, that's probably the worst bit of it, really. It's just, you know, tell all white people they're racist.
Yeah.
But I'm thinking, there's a few things...
And you're responsible for slavery.
Exactly, even though I was never there. I never enslaved anyone.
That's right.
And no one here now was enslaved. But it's still my fault, I guess.
It's your fault.
I'll take that one on the chin. Yeah. So there's a few things that stand out to me here. Is this the best use of funds, really, at the minute when we're struggling in so many different areas?
200,000. I can think of what 200,000 would do for housing.
Well, we mentioned a fund that was being set up in Warrington on the cast the other night where they were trying to raise £500,000 over 5 years. So if you're going to waste £52 million in the whole country. Maybe we should be using that. I'm worried, why is it being concealed? I know why it's been being concealed, because it's total nonsense and it's brainwashing children and staff in businesses.
Yeah.
It's a dangerous ideology. And does it work? Well, it's been proven to be completely useless. So should we have a look at how diverse Cheshire West and Chester Council are after all this?
You are the expert on these things, and we rely upon your knowledge. Go ahead.
So in their equality policy, they say, and I quote...
But if you do any more knocks on the table, I am going to kill.
Okay. Warning noted. So they quote in their equality policy, it is a promise that the council will work hard to respond to local challenges, to tackle prejudice and improve the life chances and opportunities of those who face discrimination and disadvantage. I bet you it's a bit like the Lee Anderson thing the other day. If you asked them how many people are disadvantaged, the answer will be none.
That was great. Did you see that interview where he turned around and he said, so what advantages has any white person got over anyone else? Mm. And she couldn't answer.
No.
She couldn't answer. And she said, well, I hope no advantages. And he pushed her. And she went, I'll have to come back to you on that.
Well, they actually believe that political belief is something that shouldn't be discriminated. So,
why shouldn't we ask Louise Gittins?
You know where I'm going with this.
I'm interrupting.
So, I'm actually going to say that I feel Cheshire Matters have been slightly discriminated against by Cheshire West and Chester Council.
Absolutely, because I can remember the head of legal, Vanessa Whiting, turning around and saying, no councillor has to respond.
Excellent. I also remember we rung a councillor once and she thought she'd put the phone down, but she hadn't, had she, John?
No, and we've got that audio and we're going to release it.
And
because she was being discriminatory.
She clearly explained why she didn't want to speak to us.
Correct. And she doesn't realise that we actually have that audio and we're going to release it.
So there's a first cross on your equality policy.
Indeed.
So we're going to go through this now. Pardon me. The council's workforce remains predominantly female. Do you want to have a guess at what percentage?
I would say 60-40.
Oh, no. It's gone up from 70 last year to 73%.
73% female
how
as
diverse.
Against male?
Oh,
that's diverse. And how many of that 73% are black or BAME or whatever they want to call it?
Well, we'll go through it now. So there you go. So it's female-dominated, so not equality for males, is it?
No, it isn't.
No. You've got 0.7 respondents describe their gender as non-binary. That's a whole nother discussion.
What the hell? Non-binary, non-binary. What are you? You know, are you a piece of mathematics?
I think so. Mm. Well, not right. But anyway, 0.1% trans doesn't quite match up with the 0.7 who were non-binary because I thought they were all calling themselves the same thing, but... And then you've got 0.9% stated they preferred not to say. Now, the low rate of preferred not to say responses here is encouraging, apparently, in terms of indicating willingness of council staff to enclose this data. So if you've got 0.1% trans, but 0.9% prefer not to say, that's not what they're saying. That's not encouraging.
No.
That's a lot more people who really don't want them to know their business than do. It's very intrusive.
Yeah.
So in the census... In 2021, 95.3% of Cheshire West and Chester residents reported an ethnicity within the high-level white category.
What?
It's a decrease.
Wait a minute. Let's just repeat those figures so that they know. Say it again.
95.3% residents of Cheshire West and Chester reported an ethnicity within the high-level white category.
Do you think the council actually acknowledges those figures?
Well, they tend to in here slightly. So
yeah, we're in black and white, yeah.
Yeah, but sadly, that's gone down from 2011 census, which was 97.4. So that's about 2% drop. Therefore, the number of employees self-declaring other than white would need to more than double to be truly representative of the population.
Oh, Jesus.
However, it's unlikely that the self-declared figure does underestimate the true proportion of staff belonging to non-white ethnic groups, even by a small amount. And don't worry, we've got this covered. Vegans at 0.1% as a belief.
Starve them! Starve them!
So we've got to up the vegan. That's got to get up. That is
make them eat bacon.
Yeah. So the workforce profile remains older in comparison. So there's another failure on age under the Equality Act and their policy.
So yeah, I want to know, what are the age ranges?
I don't actually remember. I don't think it actually gave them.
We should ask that question. Say how many
definitely.
Of your people are under the age of 21,
mm-hmm.
over the age of 21 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 upwards? We want to know what that is because if they are into EID, sorry, what was it?
IED.
IED. If they're into that, then they should have... A good mix. Mark, We could go and apply for jobs on Cheshire West.
Well, we need to because they need white males.
Of course they do.
Look, they've got they've only got 27% males, so they're failing on that.
Oh, they need more men. It's got to be 50-50.
So this derogatory council, it's derogatory to men. It's derogatory to young people.
Indeed.
So far. It's derogatory to the trans and the especially the vegans. Come on, vegans.
I completely blame the Labour Control Council.
Me too, for doing the opposite of what they say.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is an interesting one. Sexual orientation of well over half the workforce is unknown. That's because they don't want you prying into their personal business.
Correct.
And you shouldn't be even asking them who they
are. Yeah, I bet you they're all mostly heterosexuals. Yeah, get out.
Yeah, but what's it got to do with them? Who people want to sleep with?
Indeed.
Like, seriously, if you go into work and your boss is like, right, who do you want to sleep with this weekend? That'd be
well,
like,
I can think of a load of people at Cheshire West that I wouldn't want to sleep with.
That's what I mean. If I worked there, I'd be like, none of you lot, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
So 7.5% declare gay or bi curious, which is over the national average.
7%.
So CWAC is, well, let's just say very camp. So you can see which one of the characteristics.
Oh my God, 7%.
So you can see which one of the characteristics they're focusing on here, can't you?
Oh, Jesus.
Which will come from the Proud Trust because they're the LGBT movement.
Oh, Jesus.
So a network group exists of a number of different protected characteristics, including LGB colleagues, allies, colleagues with disabilities, and a group to encourage racial and cultural inclusion and diversity. Hang on, what a throw up. So the question was asked by Irene, what other protected characteristics are you focusing on? And their answer was, no, just that one. So just the LGBT part. So the rest of them aren't covered.
Okay,
so you
well,
can see
I think,
where they're going with this.
I think when the rest of Cheshire actually realises, why don't we do a leaflet drop of, say, like 100,000 leaflets to let everybody know in Cheshire exactly what the Labour Control Council of Cheshire West is actually thinking with their EDI?
Whatever they want it to be that day, mate, it'll probably change next week. I can't wait for the IDE.
Whatever it is, because, I mean, you know, the rest of the county will just say, do us a favour.
This is going to blow up like IDE.
Yeah.
I mean, my conclusion, this woke insanity is literally, as we keep discussing, it's destroying the quality of recruitment, which is in turn reducing the quality of the product or the service, not to mention dangerous to children, as in the schools.
Yeah,
I mean,
absolutely.
We found in that gender identity thing I did, where I looked at all the schools and I was in my report, that the majority of the 30 primary schools were pushing gender identity theory in one way or another.
Lost.
Some more extreme than others, but it was in the majority. I mean, as I say, it's dangerous to children, as well as extremely divisive. An absolute bonkers commie nonsense.
Yeah.
And it's destroying this country and its culture.
Yeah.
And I think we've just proved it's a massive waste of money, as it's detrimental and anything that it touches doesn't work. I mean, look at Cheshire West here. They're about as diverse, John, as the Taliban. Aren't they?
In terms of what, male and female?
Well, all of it, mate. Hey, you go to Iran.
Well, the Taliban wouldn't tolerate the 7%.
No, but in Iran, they've got I think they're the transgender capital of the world.
You are joking.
No, I'm not joking, because they don't want them to be gay, so they let them off sex changes for £2,000.
Good God.
I know, I won a good debate on Twitter with this one the other day. They don't like it. They can't answer. It's come from The Guardian, John. It's gospel.
It's gospel?
It's gospel.
It's got to be. It's got to be, because that's their Bible, The Guardian.
Yeah. So again, is this the best use of funds? Why is it being concealed? Are they embarrassed, ashamed? And this dangerous ideology that is completely useless needs to be eradicated.
Yeah,
so I think,
absolutely.
I think the name for this one is, I don't know, what should we call this one?
Well, I think what I would say is, I'd say to the councillors in Cheshire West and Chester, you want to keep your jobs, I would actually start questioning your management.
Yeah, because DEI is pie in the sky, isn't it?
Pie in the sky. Absolute crap.
Yeah.
They need to get it through to them. And that's it. And just a quick message. We're not going to stop. We're actually coming for you.
Yeah. We're not going to stop until you've got 50-50 male and female.
Yeah, male and female.
And 50% trans and 50% vegans. I mean, they can always come back to me if I've got this wrong, and those two mysterious positions that were redacted and no one wants, it isn't the two DEI, IED, whatever. It's all going to blow up, this, isn't it?
It is going to all
no
blow up.
No pun intended.
All right, well, there you go. You know, I'm just going to push the button on that and you'll start to hear the music underneath. There you go. I didn't like the hand movement there.
I was waving goodbye to Cheshire West.
Bye-bye.
It was a little bit of the 7%.
I know, that was the plan.
All right, sir. Take it easy.
Likewise.
Ciao.
See you later.